Hey there, my name is Tyler Nickerson with the Daily Cardinal, reporting live from Tampa Bay, Florida for the Republican National Convention. I'm sitting here with David Karst, who is the chairman of the Milwaukee Republican Party. So thank you very much for sitting down and talking
sure.
to us. Appreciate it.
Thanks for having me.
So first off, for our viewers who may not be familiar with this process, if you could just explain what a delegate actually is, I'd appreciate it.
Sure. Well, first of all, I think there's a total of 24 delegates and 24 alternates, and they are really the key grassroots of the Republican Party of Wisconsin. And we come to the national convention so we can vote for the next president of the United States, which would be Mitt Romney and the VP, which would be Paul Ryan.
Okay. So how many conventions have you been to in the past?
This is my second convention. I was in Minneapolis in 2008, and I can tell you that convention was a good convention, but this is a great convention.
Yeah.
I mean, Chairman Ryan's previous being from Kenosha, one of our own rising stars in Wisconsin, it's just a great feeling to be here, and everybody is pretty jazzed up.
Okay, being from Wisconsin, do you feel like you're getting a little bit of a special treatment?
I wouldn't say special treatment, but when you tell people that you're from Wisconsin, they're very excited and very thankful that Governor Walker started really the reform revolution in the entire state.
I'd be interested to get your take on it. We've got kind of a trifecta of Republican rock stars, if you will, from Wisconsin.
Sure.
Ryan Priebus, Scott Walker, obviously, and Paul Ryan, obviously. What makes those three special? How did they rise to national prominence?
The way they rose to national prominence is they did what they said they were going to do. They're governing the way they campaign. So if they're going to tell you that they're going to do something like Governor Walker said, he's going to do it. He's going to reform the different budgets. He's going to reform the state of Wisconsin to make it easier for the taxpayers and for young college students to get a job when they graduate.
So you did say that this convention is special. Well, what's your favorite part of conventions in general? You were the one in Minneapolis 4 years ago, you said.
Sure.
What is it about the setting, the scene that you think is special?
In my opinion, what really makes it special is to see, you know, Congressman Ryan being at the convention and being nominated as the next vice president. What's really special is, you know, typically it's Thursday night, and that's going to be an exciting night. But if you're from Wisconsin, Wednesday night is going to be very exciting to see Congressman Ryan being nominated for VP.
So why are there conventions?
Well, we are going to nominate both of them.
Yeah.
So that's the key, that they become nominated. And then the next key is to really excite the grassroots, excite the message, to hear the message, and to go out into the grassroots, to the volunteers, really the crux of the Republican Party, and get them excited so they can go to different doors, make the different phone calls, make the contacts that we need to elect Governor Romney to president.
Now I have to ask it, just because it is kind of a big deal right now, tropical storm and maybe a hurricane by now,
right.
Isaac. Obviously it's had an effect on this convention. Considering that it is kind of a coming out party for Mitt Romney, trying to introduce him to the public,
right.
There's a lot of conservative voters actually that he hasn't quite wowed, he isn't excited. Is Tropical Storm Isaac having an impact on the goal of this convention?
Well, first of all, our thoughts and prayers are with the state of Mississippi and I believe Louisiana, where Hurricane Isaac's going to hit. Does it have an impact? Well, it was a delay in one day in the convention, but in 2008, we had a delay in the convention of one day because of the hurricane that was hitting Florida at that time. But, I mean, I don't get why people say that we need to know who Governor Romney is. I mean, we know who Governor Romney is. Governor Romney was a great governor for the state of Massachusetts, and he was also a great representation, a great ambassador when he ran the Olympics, when it was in debt, when there was some very challenging times in terms of the representation. He took it over, and I think he represented the United States of America extremely well. So I don't really get into who is Governor Romney and do we get to know him and the hurricane, does it have an effect? I would say no. We know who he is.
Yeah, and let's be honest, the press is kind of playing that angle.
Right.
Though.
I mean, yesterday, even, you know, I thought the storm was going to be, or the hurricane was going to be greater, and it was a little windy here, it was a little rainy, it was sunny. money, you know.
Well, here it wasn't too bad. I think maybe the concern was that, you know, when networks are covering the convention, splitting the screen between devastation and, you know, the celebration of this convention and Republicans in general, that it doesn't quite create a positive public image.
Yeah. And it took a different turn, too. I mean, they've been watching the hurricane for, what, a week now?
Yeah, yeah. And so it wasn't quite as intense as they originally thought,
right,
I think.
Which is good. We're very thankful.
How do you feel about the press coverage thus far, then, considering the context of all this?
I think it's pretty consistent. I mean, the consistent coverage of the media is not balanced for the most part. But that's who they are, and they have a job to do, as yourself. And we have a job as Americans to elect a candidate, to put forth a candidate that can represent all Americans, that can make decisions for young people like yourself, so your future will look even brighter. I can tell you, you know, the first president that I voted for was in 1980, and that was Ronald Reagan. And I mean, he transformed America. We need to go through a transformation in America, or you know, young adults like yourself won't have that bright future as I've had, being the age that I am.
Mm-hmm. Okay, great. Well, thank you very much, David Karst, Chairman of the Republican Party of Milwaukee. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you. Thanks for having me.